If you've seen some of my maintenance videos, you'll see that I've done a little bit of work on the engine already. Mostly just maintenance stuff. When I bought the bike, the engine was in really good condition. It just needed a tune. The carburetors were completely gummed up. Valves needed adjusting. That was about it. The compression is like new. I've made these little wooden plugs. Maybe a little excessive, but I didn't want to put the parts that I just restored on here and the new rubber, so, or even the old rubber for that matter. I would have had to plug it up anyway. So this part of the video is just about getting the engine cleaned up and back in the bike. There's nothing left to do other than cosmetic stuff. Like I said, all the maintenance has been done. So without further ado, here it is. Okay, I'll try that again. So, not in a million years would I ever approve a design so utterly ridiculous and stupid. You can't get the starter out without taking this case off because there's a snap ring right there. This has to come off here in order to clear that opening because the starter's not coming out. And I looked at this before and I knew that this was gonna happen. I haven't pulled a starter out before and this is the first time. So I was expecting it, but at the same time, nothing will stun you more than something as stupid as this. So if you're out there, Mr. Yamaha engineer, and you're still around, slap yourself, please, because this is stupid. You should be able to pull a starter out and service a starter without having to crack the case like this. This is stupid. Anyway, there's a magnet here on this side, and the starter gear and the starter mechanism goes there. And I've cleaned that up a little bit. And down here, I've pulled that magnet out. It had a little bit of fuzz on it, not a lot. This one seems to be fine. I'm going to get that little ring off, get this cover off, pull the starter out. I don't see any other way to do it. Again, dumb, but has to be done. Okay, that was fun. I got the left side cover off, which is not difficult, but you still have to understand on the left side, it's a little more complicated. There's some bearings and bushings, some O-rings. Of course, you also have the starter gear came out. Just goes to show you how complicated this left side is. It's got obviously the alternator, and there's a pickup coil as well. And all of this is fed to the regulator and to the ignition module as well for timing. There's bushing with an O-ring, some other bushings, of course the starter solenoid. But there's a lot on this side, and that's why this side is the worst to sort of work on. But this kind of clearly shows where you just can't randomly pull these things off and go get them re-chromed, because there's more to it. There's so much more to it than that. Get it all disassembled, and then for both sides, I'm going to get all the pitted chrome removed and then polish them. It's gonna be a lot of work. A little bit easier on this side. I have had this side off before in the past, and that's to repair a clutch. It's pretty straightforward. Bolts come off, all the plates come out, and you replace the plates, and that's really about it. There's really nothing much to do unless you're overhauling an engine on this side. Clutch is about it, and pretty straightforward. So that side's off. That was a little easier than the other side. Of course, still got the starter to deal with. I'm just going to go up and review, just make sure I'm doing that right, because I'm pretty sure all I had to do was just slide that top part off on the other side. So I'm not going to manhandle anything more. I'm just going to have a read, make sure I'm doing the right thing, and then I'll come back down and finish pulling the starter out. So this is it. The two side covers have been removed. The left one, a little more of a challenge than the right one for obvious reasons. Those explained. In fact, the starter is still sitting inside. I'll tackle that a little bit later. I'm not really too concerned about it. Of course, it's going to come out. But these are all the parts that came off. Keep everything sort of organized. Take lots of photos. Left side, the service manual is pretty good too, but I still take lots of pictures and compare them to the service manual, because sometimes people work on bikes and they put stuff back together wrong. So, clutch cable cover, the clutch is still, or the clutch pusher, whatever the hell that thing's called, the actuator, is still on the that cover. I'll attend to that later. So, clutch cover and the hardware. This is all the engine bolts. I'll clean those up. We're all going to get some stainless steel ones. I'm not sure yet. And that's a little snap ring that goes on the starter. Solenoid sitting out here pretty all by yourself, enjoying life. That's a starter mechanism. And if you ever have this come apart on you, and you go, oh my God, which way did this go? Because it almost looks symmetrical. And there's wear marks on both sides. The dead giveaway would be the most solid post goes into the engine. That's where all of the force is. And this part that has some threads in it, that is actually what this screws into from the solenoid. So if you ever get this mixed up, this part with the threads sits that way. Anyway, that's the whole starter mechanism. It goes together one way and one way only. Good exploded view of this in the service manual, but take lots of pictures. Solenoid actuation is here. Solenoid cover is there. Solenoid cover on the other side, a little plastic cover, is right here. This needs to get prettied up. And, let's see what's on this side. So right side cover, there's just bushing, oil filter cover, all the bolts, all the hardware. That's got to get cleaned up. These are the little oilers. They run off from the bottom, pumped up through the top, and then allow the drain back. These are the five bolts. And all this will come apart even further, and I'm going to clean all this stuff up. Starter's out, and all it was, yes, that little C-clip holds this whole thing in, but it's also a bit of a friction fit. I just didn't want to haul on it, but all you really had to do is, as you pull the starter out, just tap on the end of that, and this gear will, basically this whole thing will stay inside the engine case, and this will just come out. Thanks, Joe. You know who you are. The manuals both suck. The Haynes and the Climber manual don't say anything about getting that starter out that way. There it is. Oh, she's looking pretty bare. Yeah. Oh, yeah. So basically, whole outside part stayed inside the case. And I just tapped on the shaft and it went through. So that's where I am at. Yeah, so now it's time to start thinking about prepping this for paint. Again, this is all just purely cosmetic. I'm gonna probably use my I have a little sandblaster, and I'm gonna probably use the baking soda. Hello, baking soda. Just to rough up the paint, and then I'm just gonna basically just spray bomb it. All right, I've got everything masked that I don't want blasted or painted. Old spark plugs, not too concerned about those. Everything else is clean. I've got the bottom painted and some clear on it, but that was just to get the bottom painted and protected. And a little extra paint, a little extra clear, just because of the rocks and chips and stuff. I just don't want the bottom chipping. So it's done. Next step is to soda blast this, and it's not to get the paint off completely. There's a lot of chipping on the front. I'll show you that. Quite a bit of chipping, actually. But otherwise, the bike's in really good shape. There's no damage. It's just wear and tear. So soda blasting, my little homemade soda blaster. Show you that here in a second. I'll cover this up, of course, and then in the morning I'll spray painting. It's getting late in the day here. So stuff I'm using for paint, hard to believe that's $70 worth of paint, but welcome to Canada. I don't know, that's probably about 50 bucks. It's still pretty expensive stuff. It's $23 a can here in Canada. Probably going to use one can anyway, and maybe a little bit more of this, and then just a very, it'll be a lighter coat of that clear. I don't want the engine too glossy, but the idea, of course, is to get it looking as original as possible. Okay, as far as the soda blaster goes, it's this really cheap, the cheapest piece of crap I could find, and just as long as it worked. It's got the smallest nozzle in there. I have a bottle full of baking soda. It probably isn't rough enough that it could take the paint right off, but that's not the purpose here. The purpose is just to scuff the paint up so this paint will have something to stick to. I'll do all the soda blasting off camera, and then I'll show you what it looks like in stages. I'll show you what the engine looks like once I'm done all this. Cool. All right, that's it. All blasted with my little homemade soda blaster. The compressor kind of struggled with, even with that tiny little nozzle. It was on constantly, but this only took about 10 minutes. It looks really good. I got in all the little nooks and crannies, even underneath where the carburetor is. You still see some of the little paint chips in there. But overall, you know, this side and the other side, everything turned out really good. There's now it's pretty obvious where the paint was loose and chipping. The bottom of this is painted, of course. And now I'm just going to basically do from, you know, from there up. I'll just use a piece of cardboard or whatever to mask that. But that's it. I'm going to wipe it down with solvent now, leave it sit overnight, and then I'll come back in the morning one last time. I'll just blow all the dust off it with the compressor and then shoot it with my paint. That's the VHT brand caliper paint. The color is great, and it's a really durable high-temperature paint, good for 900 degrees. So that's coming up next. Cool. All right, here it is. End of the day. After a couple of coats of the high temperature silver, which looks pretty good. Yeah, nice even coats. It seems like it's gotten in all the hard spots to reach. Looks pretty good. It's got a nice sort of a, well, this has got a bit of a matte finish to it, actually more than a gloss. There's no gloss to this at all. So I'm not sure the durability as far as, you know, just things like abrasion resistance, like just rubbing up against it. Obviously when it dries, it's gonna harden a little bit more than what it is right now. I'm gonna let this sit overnight, and then what I'll do, let's see the front. Looks pretty good. Of course, the bottom's already done. It's got a clear on it too, but the clear was done mostly just for protection from road impacts like stone chips and stuff like that. But the silver looks really good. And I know the engine, I remember the engine, you know, the original paint did have a little bit of a, like a satin finish to it. That paint goes on really well. You gotta really be careful with it too, because it goes on pretty heavy in a way that you got to keep your distance from what you're painting, or else you'll start getting, it'll get building up, it'll build up really quick, and you'll get some really weird flaking and some really weird colors in it. So it's almost like you got to sort of dust it on like a base coat, but it seems to be nice and even. I love that. Yeah, the color looks great. It looks really OEM. It's got a real nice aluminum finish to it. It's kind of hard to see with the phone and this crappy light, but I'm gonna let it sit overnight, and I think, like I said, what the plan is going to be is I'm gonna do the cylinder heads with the high temperature clear, and then I'm just gonna do the satin on the bottom. Cool. All right. I'm so impatient. I can't even wait for paint to dry. Next morning, looks pretty good. The paint looks nice and bright, especially in the light. But I can kind of guess just by looking at it that it's not going to have very good abrasion resistance. So I'm just going to blow the whole thing down with the compressor and then just give it a light clear. That'll hopefully not take away from this nice shine. All right, let's do that. Okay, that's one coat, actually no, two coats of silver and two coats of clear. And the clear goes on, again, this paint goes on really heavy, so you gotta keep your distance from it or it will run. And I notice this clear does yellow things up a little bit, which is why I was a little bit light on the clear, but very close to original, which is what I'm after. And of course, where this part joins up to the backside of the engine where the drive shaft goes, that's got to match too, because the original, the paint was all one color. So that's really close to the swing arm as far as the color goes. The finish looks really close to the OEM finish. And just got a little bit of gloss to that clear, which is perfect. So I'm gonna let this set up, let it all dry, and then I'm gonna take the mask off. Thank you.